Hello, friends. So, in the past, I have quoted both Max Planck and Erwin Schrödinger as having favored consciousness as the fundamental reality of all existence. So, let me share with you in a little bit detail what they each said and why I am totally in agreement with their views, not that it matters to anyone. So Max Planck made the statement, "You cannot get behind consciousness." And it reflected his philosophical view that consciousness is a fundamental aspect of reality. Planck was a pivotal figure in the development of quantum theory and regarded consciousness as primary and matter derivative of it. I, of course, believe that matter is a human construct or modes of knowing and experience in consciousness that we call perceptual activity, a combination of sensations. In any case, Max Planck's perspective suggests that all discussions and perceptions of existence inherently require consciousness as a prerequisite. In other words, consciousness is not something that can be further reduced or explained away by other phenomena. It is the foundational basis upon which all else is understood. So that was Planck. And then, of course, a contemporary, although born later, of his, Erwin Schrödinger, from whom we have the whole basis of quantum mechanics, which is the wave function. He had a profound interest, Erwin Schrödinger, in Eastern philosophies, particularly Vedanta, which influenced his scientific thinking. Schrödinger compared the concepts of Atman, the individual self, and Brahman, the universal self, from Vedanta to his wave function in quantum mechanics. In Vedantic philosophy, Atman and Brahman are the ultimate reality, and they're ultimately also the same, reflecting a unity between the individual and the universe. Yatha pinde, tatha brahmande. As is the atom, so is the universe. As is the microcosm, so is the macrocosm. As is the human body, so is the cosmic body. As is the human mind, so is the cosmic mind. So Schrödinger saw a parallel in the wave function, which describes the possibilities of a system's states and reflects a holistic view of reality, where individual particles are part of a larger, interconnected, or inseparable whole. Both Planck's and Schrödinger's views highlight a philosophical dimension to their scientific work, where consciousness and holistic unity play central roles in understanding the nature of reality. These perspectives challenge the purely mechanistic, materialistic, and reductionist views of the universe, suggesting instead that consciousness and interconnectedness or inseparability or non-local correlation are fundamental aspects of existence. So why is this important? Because this points to your existence as fundamental to the universe, because the ground of your being is the ground of all being. Let me know if this is useful. And by the way, once again, reminder, Digital Dharma is out, and it's a user's guide to how AI can elevate spiritual intelligence and personal well-being. So you can also engage with my digital twin, digitaldeepak.ai, and we can continue these conversations if, of course, you have the time, ability, and desire to do so.